What's up, tech fans? Exciting news on the Intel forefront. Now, we all know that AMD has been putting a hurting to Intel for quite a while, especially when it comes to the nanometer process. With Zen 4 going down to 5 nanometers and now Intel barely doing 10 nanometers, you'd think that there'd be no competition, but you'd be wrong. The new 12900K CPU that's coming out from Intel looks to be a beast of a CPU, and it looks like Intel's coming back to the mat. Let's talk tech, Intel style. Did you just build yourself a brand new PC? Or did you just upgrade your old PC, but find you're in need of a Windows 10 key? If that's the case, your CD key has you covered. And buying, it's never been easier. All you do is go to your CD key website, find the Windows software that you want to buy, put it into your cart, enter the code TOT20, apply the code, save yourself some extra money, and as soon as you complete your purchase, the Windows 10 key will be in your inbox. There's no problems, it's really easy, and all keys are guaranteed to work, so you don't have to worry about losing your money, and you'll have a valid Windows 10 key to get your unit up and running. Before we jump into the heart of the matter, I'd really ask that you guys could do me a courtesy and like and share this video on social media. If you also like what you'd see, I'd really dig it if you'd subscribe to the channel and turn on that notification bell, as your viewership is always important. Alder Lake is the latest CPU branding coming from Intel. And this is the very first Intel CPU that is deviated from their other CPUs in the architecture and the way that it's made. Now the new CPU, it's a hybrid CPU that uses two different types of cores in one die. Now the first is the big CPU, the 10 nanometer Sunny Cove. Now this CPU is higher clocked for major tasks and applications, and it's the power. And the other chips are smaller 10 nanometer small cores, and these are used for background tasks. Now, like I said, this is an entirely new take on CPUs from Intel, and it's something that has never been done or seen before. These chips were originally developed with ARM technology for the mobile market, and that does make sense, but for desktop CPUs, it was a bit confusing. However, after some initial news has been leaked, it seems that any concerns over this have been completely squashed. A new qualification sample of the 12900K is showing extreme performance gains, putting any doubts I had to rest and probably putting your doubts to rest as well. First off, there was a link on NGA forums and then a follow-up on video cards. And both of these show that Intel seems to be back in the game, showing a single core turbo frequency of 5.3 megahertz on the big CPU and 3.9 gigahertz on the small CPU. And these new CPUs will be built on Intel's enhanced 10 nanometer super thin process. The really big news is an estimated R20 score predicts that the new 12900K should score 11,300. And we also know that Cinebench scales really nicer with higher clock speeds. And although these first scores are based off the initial CPU, with new developments, these scores could be even higher when the CPUs get released to the market. Plus, even if that score was a little bit lower, it's still kicking ass on the AMD 5950 that shows a score of 10,400. Both Intel's new CPU and AMD's top dog have 16 cores. But the design architecture with the big and small cores on the Intel side will be a very interesting thing to see when it's in action. In most likelihood, the new 12900K is set to compete with the 5900X. Not the 5950X, but it may just smash that as well from these preliminary numbers. I am sure that at this point, AMD is not going to want to take the backseat to Intel whatsoever, and their new Zen 4 5 nanometer chips are right around the corner, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see how things play out. So in conclusion, It really looks like Intel is back in action again with the new 12900K CPU. The technology that they're using and the way they're doing it is very interesting. Mixing two different types of cores in a CPU in a single die is something that hasn't been done before. And honestly, it will probably have AMD scrambling to try to figure out what to do to compete with that. I mean, let's just face it, if you can mix all the great things about ARM technology and get great battery life and all that type of stuff, which is perfect for the mobile world, plus you can add all the power of like having a big beefy engine in your car, come on, that is a great thing. And I'm really glad to see that Intel's going to be back in the game. Now, the CPU hasn't officially been launched to the market, but like I said during the video, so far, the preliminary results are just looking awesome. And even though this CPU, I always got GPUs in my mind. This new CPU is going to be very competitive. Price-wise, it's probably going to be coming to market, like I said, competing with their 5900X. But from the numbers that we're seeing so far, it even may blow the 5950X out of the water. So for those people who have been, you know, boo-hooing for Intel for a while, I mean, I did a little bit of that too, because why not, you know? When Intel lags, you gotta kick them to make them wake the frack up and get on their feet again. But it looks like they've done it. So once again, let me know what you guys think in the comments section down below. Your viewership and all of your comments and stuff, they help make the channel because you're just as much a part of this as I am. Also, all of the Windows keys codes that were sold in the beginning are always guaranteed. And if you want to support the channel and don't have any money at all, I have a link down below for Amazon Prime. They've won like 11 Emmys for all of their TV shows, so you know they're making good stuff. So you can try Prime, try all that other stuff. And if you have a single dollar, you can support me on Patreon. So we'll see you guys back here on the channel for more tech and more interesting things. Peace.